Wizards of the West Coast, tapping out, slinging spells. I hate your deck.
Are you going to tap a crack a second?
I'm going to tap a crack a second.
I fantasized about, I can play this or this combination.
That was before there was food support.
If you really want to support I Hate Your Deck, there's a lot of ways to help support us. Number one way is through Patreon. Patreon is a great place where you get to join our community. We have a Discord where we play a lot of Magic with our friends, and there's such a community of people from around the world in our Discord. So if you want access to our deck list, do you want to play Magic with a lot of people from all over the world and interact or help brew your decks, the I Hate Your Deck Discord through Patreon will help you get all that done. Hey, if you've been liking I Hate Your Deck, hit the like, subscribe, and ring that bell to get notifications when we have new episodes coming out. And we also have bonus episodes. If you want to see those bonus episodes that were too hot for YouTube, join our Patreon to check that out.
Wizards of the West Coast, tapping out, slinging spells. I Hate Your Deck. We want to give you the true LGS experience. We show up, sling spells, and have fun. Now meet our players for this episode.
What's up, everyone? It's Lynch from I Hate Your Deck.
Yeah!
And as always, I love playing paper magic with my friends. Woo! And I also have some awesome spicy people here from all around. I got patrons. If anyone gets hating each other's decks, who gets the saltiest and who gets the happiest?
Hey guys, Sean, I'm back. Fan of the show, friend of the show. Here to play some magic with some friends. Can't wait to get into it. Let's do it.
I'm John, hopefully back to rain some more terror as I usually do, but we'll see. Always glad to see all my good friends and stuff here. I mean, coming enough now, we're all just buddies now, I feel.
We're friends.
Hell yeah, magic brings people together.
Together.
That's frenemies. The gathering.
Until we draw. My name is Ray. I don't like friends. I don't like fun.
I hate playing paper magic.
I hate playing paper magic with my friends.
Yeah.
No, I am here to have a good time. I love I Hate Your Deck. I'm here to sling spells and make jokes when I lose.
Let's talk about rule zero. So I would like to play the Lord of the Rings Saruman, the Dark Lord, because I grew up loving Lord of the Rings. Huge fan. Are you guys cool with the universe beyond Lord of the Rings, Commander?
Absolutely.
Yeah, absolutely.
I do have some fast mana vault, mana crypt. Don't have Jeweled Lotus. It's a decent mana package. Having a big commander, you know, is important. So Saruman, the Dark Lord, 3 generic blue, black, red, legendary creature, avatar horror. Ward, sacrifice a legendary artifact or legendary creature. So I love the ward part of that. Because it really makes you have to like sacrifice something you care about.
So gross.
Whenever an opponent casts a spell, it's all you, I get to amass one.
Nice.
Whenever an army you control deals combat to a player, the ring tempts me. And I am looking to tempt myself a lot in this deck. I could have put like Razzcath and a bunch of other like, you know, made this almost like a CDH shell, but I decided not to do that. Instead, I've got the 9 Nazgul.
Yeah.
I have the Witch King.
More on theme.
For the most part, I really am trying to optimize the Lord of the Rings flavor by still making it as strong as it can be, but with the Lord of the Rings cards. The only like, you know, I would say CDH staple card that's really in here besides, you know, the fast mana would be like Gilded Drake, you know? But Gilded Drake is such a great card, you know? Sometimes there are stretches you just can't get to, and to be able to steal one of someone's best creature is amazing. The last thing I forgot to read is, whenever the ring does tempt me, I may discard my hand. If you do, draw 4 cards.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So it gets to a great part where like, hopefully, ideally, I have no cards in hand when that happens, so I can just draw and then every, you know, and then hopefully I can keep playing it out. Yeah. When I play in Modern Arena, that's what I get to do a lot. You play all your stuff, just discard your hand, take it, next turn, play out your hand, discard nothing, draw. So like, all will be one is in here because the fact that the amass counters, and then again, there's a lot, the race do the counters, the Nazgul.
It reads like a planeswalker almost.
He is Sauron, the Dark Lord. He is the like the big baddie of Lord of the Rings, so he should be badass.
Just for the record, the last time I had never seen any Lord of the Rings, I watched all of them in about 2 days. So I went crazy. I said it was for research purposes so I could play magic better.
Respect. Respect.
So I watched them all, so now I know what's going on.
If there's anything that I've done now that's been good in your life, it's that you got to watch Peter Jackson's Lord of the Rings.
Yeah, exactly, because I played Sam and Frodo and I was like, they could be friends.
You watched the 3 Hobbit movies?
I watched those. I watched the extended versions of the long ones because I said, I just watched the regular ones.
My man.
I'm no rookie nerd, okay? Hell yeah.
I would have loved it. You know what? Yeah, dude. I am playing Ovika, Enigma
Goliath. It's a 5 colorless, a blue and a red, for a legendary Phyrexian Nightmare. 6/6, flying, ward 3 colorless, and you have to pay 3 life. I'm hopping on the ward train two over wards. Here, you know? Also has, whenever you cast a non-creature spell, create X11 red Phyrexian goblin creature tokens, where X is the mana value of that spell. They gain haste until end of turn. It does have, like we were talking about with Rule 0, it does have, like, you know, a little bit faster mana base because Ovika is 7 mana to get out. Then usually do stuff either the same turn or hopefully, you know, with the ward ability, stick around for at least one turn to untap and do some shenanigans from there. Not running a Jeweled Lotus, but I am running Mana Vault, I believe, and some other stuff like Rim Monolith and stuff like that to try to get some fast mana out there. The deck's playing non-creature spells, so there's pretty crazy things out there. Expropriate probably being the big baddie of the deck. Omniscience.
I think I've actually played, now I think I remember playing against this deck, because I think I've definitely had to deal with your expropriate issues.
We did, yeah, I think you did play against this deck. It's got some pretty fun stuff that can get a little out of hand. And it's red-blue, so it's Spellslinger, but also has like a small goblin sub-theme, because it makes goblins and they give them haste. The goblins come out, they may have some ETBs or, you know, stuff like that, and then want to swing with them. Direct damage, non-combat damage, or just attacking with combat. And there you go.
Nice.
So I got Kitt Kanto, the Mayhem Diva. She is a legendary cat bard druid. It says, when Kitt Kanto enters the battlefield, I get a 1/1 green and white citizen creature token. At the beginning of combat on each player's turn, I may tap 2 untapped creatures I control. When I do, the target creature that that player controls gets +2/+2 and gains trample until the end of turn, and it's goaded. I built this deck because I love goading, but I think as a lot of people realize when goad became an evergreen keyword, it's really hard to just win when you're just goading all the time. So very standard, kind of like Jetmir style build, but with her as the commander, so I can goad a lot of 1/1 creatures, get them out. Usually I'm trying to goad everybody on every turn, and then I have a lot of things to finish out the game, like Craterhoof, In Race Forerunners, stuff like that. You know, standard, like, I'm small, now I'm big, right? No longer small, big now. Because I have original LS Norn, so obviously the -2 to everybody else's. That's, yeah, I know, but how can you not run her in something like this, right?
No.
Technically have Might Overseer, who makes those little 1/1 mites, but he's more to give my tokens first strike kind of thing, right?
So. Kitt Kanto definitely sounds like the most southern commander.
Kitt Kanto, she's a cat bar druid.
Everything going on there is just like
cat bar druid.
I'm here to end meal. I'm playing Sir Ginger the Meal Ender. It is a 3/1 food knight for 2 colorless. It says Sir Ginger the Meal Ender has trample, hexproof, and haste as long as an opponent controls a planeswalker. You guys remember from the first Eldraine trailer back in the day, her boyfriend got eaten by Garrett, so she gets pissed off, which is why she's riding the gingerbread horse. That's why it has some planeswalker hate. Garruk ate her boyfriend. It's tough.
It's a big flavor win, but it's weird because it's magic lore flavor.
Genji also has, whenever another artifact you control is put into a graveyard from the battlefield, put a +1/+1 counter on Genji and scry 1. And I can pay 2, sack Genji, and I gain life equal to its power. I'm here to swing with Genji. I'm tired of losing. I have killed myself, got one-shotted, had my lands destroyed, board wiped. Point is, I'm here to win. I'm tired of losing. I have a couple pieces of fast mana. I have a Mox Opal, a Mana Vault, and then I crit. Because I'm in colorless, so I'm limited. I feel like the fact that I can't really cast instants and sorceries makes up for the fact that I get to use fast mana.
It's so on theme since you love food.
If there's one person that builds every food commander, it's me.
Yeah, the first one I played against you was Guillaume. Guillaume, the Master Chef.
Yeah, that was
Guillaume
before was there was so food support.
Yeah, really, seriously.
He was the original food master, for
sure. He was doing things with food.
I'd just be cooking, you know what I'm
100%.
Saying?
100%.
Keep cooking. I hate your deck.
Yeah. Should we roll to see who goes first?
Yes.
Where'd you get these dice?
2. Man, I rolled too fast.
Four, wait, did we three. Say lower?
At least I'm second. Get her 7.
Last time I heard that, I fell off my dinosaur.
Draw. Ooh, that was a top deck for the ages.
Oh my god.
Play an island and cast a
sword. Oh my god, I do it.
Kill that.
The 8th card.
All right, I scooped the game.
Now let's hope I can pass top the turn. Deck.
No follow-up, no follow-up.
I do want to point out in Rule 0, he mentioned that when his commander is out, he said, hopefully it's out for more than one turn so I can do shenanigans and win.
Yeah.
So we all know when that thing comes out.
Save 3 mana and 3 life. I'll draw for turn. No, I didn't get a Soul Ring, but I did get a land I needed.
Are you going to tap a crack a second?
I'm going to tap a crack a second. I'll pass while you get the bad.
Yes.
Sorry.
I'm gonna play Urza's Power Plant. It taps for 1 colorless, and if I have Urza's Mine, Urza's Tower, and Urza's Power Plant,
I'll get the Xander's Lounge because I can, and it has all 3, and I'll come and tap. That's right, then you can.
If I control Urza's Mine, Urza's Tower, and Urza's Power Plant, this taps for 2 colorless instead.
Tron's gross, bro.
I will tap 1 colorless. I will play a Sign Soul Ring.
He's gonna make you fear the Ginger.
I will then tap 2 colorless, play Sir Ginger. They are here. It is here.
Turn one commander's pretty good.
Jinji has trample, hexproof, and haste as long as opponent controls a planeswalker. Whenever another artifact I control is put into a graveyard from the battlefield, put a plus one counter on Saint Ginger and scry one. Pay two, tap it, sack it, and I gain life equal to its power. I will play Mox Opal. It taps for one mana of any color, and I can only activate this if I control three more artifacts.
Dude, you're on the and warpath.
Golly,
he was not
I
joking
do.
About coming to win, dude.
Yeah, yeah, I'm pissed off. I'll tap the one. I'll play Wayfarer's Bond.
You are joking, dude.
I'm so proud of you.
I'm doing the fucking thing.
I'm gonna overload Vandal.
If I leave today with not one win.
So dazzling.
It has pay two, tap it, sack it, look for basic land from the battlefield tapped, and shuffle. Your turn.
Now you must wait like the rest of us. I thought I did really good by getting a fetch land.
All right, I'm gonna play Iganjo Castle. It's a legendary land that taps for white mana, or I can pay a white, tap it, and prevent the next two damage that will be dealt to target legendary creature this turn. Pasta the Fazolis.
You are, god damn it, Ray.
Woo!
I had two options turn one. Well, anyway, I'm going to play this mountain as my land for turn.
Better get off your boot-licking straps.
You have so many cards in hand, I have to try. Yeah, but I'm going to cast a Mystic Remora, which was what I was going to cast turn one.
That's okay.
Nothing. I'm going to pass the turn after that.
Untap. Draw.
Ooh,
such a strong.
Are you sure?
That was the Nazgul.
I was going to say.
You know, I was doing the Lord of the Rings.
Yeah. Play Shrine of the Forsaken Gods. It taps for a colorless, and it taps for two colorless if I control seven or more lands. I sure don't. I'll tap the Sol Ring for two, the Mox Opal for one, three colorless. I'll play Sword of Fire and Ice. It's an equipment that says equipped creature gets +2/+2 and has protection from red and blue. Whenever equipped creature deals combat damage to a player, Sword of Fire and Ice deals two damage to any target, and you draw a card.
I will draw a card from Mr. Gamora.
Yes. I will then pay two, move to equip the Sword of Fire and Ice.
Okay.
Also,
depending on who you're going to attack, I may or may not have a response.
Not at you.
Fair enough. But you should have a response. This dude is just blasting.
Pro red blue, but friends with you.
Yeah. Then you had that turn one, right? I'm gonna attempt the Swords of Plowshares, Jinji, before she gets equipped.
Okay. That's the foil version of the Warhammer?
Of course, Lynch, of course. Why not live luxuriously?
Sir Ginger will die.
Actually, she'll be exiled.
Power?
It's power.
Oh, power, you gain three life.
Yeah, swords. That's the problem. People get so salty when they get a sword or path. They're like, fine, and they forget. You get to get a land. You gain life. You know, it's like, I've been sword and life, totally forgotten to gain life.
Yeah.
When you just get salty that your big like, creature. Oh. Like, when your big creature gets exiled, there's nothing more salt-inducing.
All right, pass the turn.
All right, untap.
You did a lot, don't be so bad. Sure.
I'm gonna play the Sungrass Prairie. I can pay a mana and it will give me green and white mana. Then I will pass.
Oh, wait, you cast that. You didn't Mr. Grimora.
And I also did not pay for the Swords of Plowshares.
You may, I missed that trigger. Bummer.
May sucks.
Yep, they don't print them with May no more.
Untap, upkeep, I will pay two to pay for the cumulative upkeep on here. Leaving one floating, then it will go away when I draw. I'll draw for turn. I'll play a Shivan Reef. I will then pay a red and a blue, and I will cast Third Path Iconoclast. It's a 2-1. Whenever you cast a non-creature spell, create a 1-1 colorless soldier artifact creature token. Like a little baby Ovika. Pass the turn.
Pass this is holy. I'm gonna draw a only because he said it. I was trying to be cool.
He's saying Pasta Fazoli.
Pasta the Fazoli.
I'm gonna play Mountain. I'm gonna tap three. I'm gonna cast Cerberic Study. Response.
Do you pay the Mystic?
I can't.
I won't draw a card.
Good thing you remembered. Because he forgot earlier.
Because I already forgot.
I am passing.
Untap, upkeep, draw.
Now I gotta remember with you. Let's pay attention.
I'll play a Wastes. I'll pay three. I'll do Foundry Inspector. Artifact spells cost one less to cast.
There is a trigger on the stack. Are you paying?
No.
Only Ristic, solamente amigo.
I will draw without you.
No responses.
I'll pay three. I'll play Sir Ginger. Everyone,
leave me alone.
It costs one less because of Foundry Inspector. I'll sit here with no attaches, no swings, just friends, and pass.
All right.
I will untap my untapped.
Now let me draw one.
Friends forever.
We've been friends.
I must remind you, you only drew one, yet he played two spells. And it is a matrix.
Oh!
I got you so have missed caught one.
On. Now I have missed a trigger.
And you were just roasting them about
I know.
I just drew, I'm gonna play my Osgiliath, the Fallen Capital, or Core Haven for you lay folks. It taps for colorless, or I may pay a white and a colorless, tap it, and prevent all combat damage will be dealt by target attacking creature this turn. Maze of Ith Light, if you will.
See, nothing's more LGS than missing your triggers.
I know, huh?
So then I will pass Pasta the Fazolis.
All right, untap, upkeep. I will pay two with my Soul Ring on the Mystic Remora. Then I will draw for turn. I will play Mountain as my land for turn. I'll pay three, because it's so awesome to pay three for an Is It Signet.
Oh, you're paying for Ristic, huh?
Taxed. That will trigger my third path Iconoclast, and I will make a 1/1 colorless soldier artifact creature token. No, I have to take the shot, because I cast the wrong spell. I'm an idiot, yeah.
Take back shot?
Yes.
If okay, take back shot, take hot shot. Shot sauce.
Let's see it.
1, 2, 3, yee. Oh, no, it didn't even move. Okay. Go.
I think that was against the Geneva Convention.
Untaxed, Impact Tremors.
Yes.
Okay. Makes a soldier. Yeah, I just...
Untaxed, I draw.
Untaxed, yeah.
So said untaxed, untaxed, I draw.
Untaxed is a signet. Make another one.
I draw. Take. Just I draw. Remember that you did. Right? I draw?
You do take one.
You have two.
I know, that is true.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm going to swing at you for two.
Yeah. That makes sense.
You drew cards the black way with one damage per card draw. Oh my god, right. I hate my life.
I'm going to play another Lord of the Rings island.
Huge.
Riverdale. Don't quote the old magic to me, witch. I was there for when they were written.
I'm gonna tap four.
Okay.
I'm gonna cast Relic of Sauron. Not paying.
Untaxed. I will draw.
I'm gonna tap two black to cast an arcane signet. Draw.
That's crazy, by the way.
What?
All this untaxing and no one would let me draw one card from sword.
We all just want to catch up to you. How cool you are.
I mean, look at your
I'm
start.
I'm going to tap the arcane signet for a shadow sphere.
Hello?
Okay.
Shadow sphere scary.
It's coming in hot.
Yeah. Shadow sphere scary.
Untax, yeah.
Untap, upkeep, draw a card. I'm going to cast an ancient tomb.
So now we're tied.
Now we're tied. Before I forget.
You look like you're struggling over there.
It's not like the other times I've taken those shots. I've taken shots, dude. That was a chunky shot, bro. Yeah,
that looked gross.
Okay, I want to point out before I forget. Oh my god. Hold your laugh.
Just go, shit, dude. Go.
Okay, I just want to point out that all the cool shiny versions of the cards you see are courtesy of my friend Daniel. So thank you for letting me borrow the cool shiny versions of the cards.
Hell yeah, Daniel.
Hell yeah. This is still the ancient tomb I stole from David.
Hashtag not sponsored by David.
I asked him if he wanted it back. He said no. My ancient tomb. I'll tap, lose two. I'm gonna play Blackblade Reforged. Actually, it only costs one. I'm just gonna tap this and it's down.
To deny two draws?
No.
Don't forget to gain your two life back. That
so I'm drawing.
We're friends.
Yep.
Thanks. Page two.
Be patient, Viceroy. She will die.
I wanna move Sword of Fire and Ice to Sir Jim.
Mm-hmm.
5-3, swinging your way for how much you've drawn. It is protection from red, blue, and if it deals combat damage, it pings something for two and I draw a card. I will not ping you, leave me alone.
In response to attackers being called, I'm going to activate Osgiliath and prevent all combat damage that would be dealt by that card until the end of turn.
Ray's like, I gotta think now.
I gotta pay two, I don't have anything else to do. I'm gonna sack Wave for his bauble.
Get a
artifact leaves the battlefield. She gets a +1/+1 counter. And I'm gonna go look for a basic land.
Are you okay? It comes at you in waves, bro.
Earlier that I already went to combat. Good.
Okay, I will and I will draw. Well, as much fun as it be to be just ruining Ray's fun the entire game, I am gonna have to eventually play a spell.
Thank you.
So I'm gonna pay three. And I'm gonna play Eidolon of Countless Battles. It has Bestow, but I'm not doing the Bestow ability. It says the Eidolon of Countless Battles and the enchanted creature that I bestow it upon each get +1/+1 for each creature I control and for each aura I control. I only control one creature. It's just a 1/1. Not very fun right now, but c'est la vie. And then I'll pass.
Before you pass, though, on your cast, though, are you paying for... Did you pay Ristic?
I am not. So you may draw, good sir.
I was just letting you read your card, but yes, thank you.
I'm tap. Upkeep. I'm going to upkeep. Remora will die. I will draw for turn. Play a Steam Vents as my land for turn. When it enters the battlefield, I may pay two life. If I don't, it enters the battlefield tapped. I'll pay two life. I'm gonna tap for three. I'm going to cast a Witty Roastmaster.
Taxed or untaxed?
Untaxed.
So I draw.
When it enters the battlefield, each of you will take a damage from the Impact Tremors. One damage there. Backwards, everybody's gonna give me shit for it. I'm gonna cast Purphoros.
You should have done that other
taxed.
Way.
I should have done it the other
way. Hey, if you'd done it the other way, you know, you would have been able to do a little bit.
And I'm not going to get any triggers for it. He's a creature when I cast him, so I don't get a trigger from here. When he enters the battlefield, checks my devotion. 1, 2, 3, 4. He is not a creature, so he does not trigger Witty or Impact.
That sucks.
Yeah, bro, but I did pay the tax. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then I'm going to go to combat. I'm going to continue swinging on Lynch for drawing so many cards.
for four.
I go down.
Oh, I'm sorry, for three. For three, I'll keep one back. One,
yeah, two, three. So I go to 33. Untap, draw. I'll tap six, four lands, this for two black. I'll go ahead and I'll put Sauron the Dark Lord on the stack. Okay, he ETBs. I now can play land. I'll play Barad-dûr.
Barad-dûr.
It doesn't enter tap because I control legendary creature and it can tap for black. Two. Mm-hmm. Cast a Lightning Greaves.
No response.
And I will attempt to move Lightning Greaves onto Sauron the Dark Lord. Now it's hasty. I probably should just go at you and make you at least start getting rid of your
I'm
stuff.
Burning from the inside out.
So okay. I'm gonna attempt to go to combat first. Okay. I will then attempt to swing the Dark Lord toward your red-blue booty.
All right, well, my colorless booty will block it, jumping it.
Today is not that day.
I pass. Take it away, Ray.
Untap.
My name is not Raymond. Do call me Ray.
Draw. I'll play two with the Spirit Dragon. I'm gonna pay two. This costs one less because of Foundry Inspector, and then I'll pay the tax with the other colorless. So this is Conchorn. I can pay one, tap it, sack it. I can draw two cards and put any one card from my hand back on top of my library.
That will trigger, though, his ability to amass one orc.
Okay.
Army.
Then I'll move to do that thing. I'll pay one, tap it, sack it. I'll draw two cards. When this leaves, I get to get a plus and counter and scry one. I'm scry. I want to keep it there. Then I'll draw two. And I put that one back on top. I'll pay three to attach Black Raid Reforge to Sajinja. He gets +1/+1 for each land I control. Right now is six. So right now he's pro red blue, +10 pro red blue, 13, 11. Oof. I'm gonna go to combat. I'm gonna do something today, damn it. I will swing you with the massive board, pro red blue.
Yeah, I have no blocks with that.
Cause I can
so
just
I have
jump
to take
block.
13. Yep. So I take 13.
I have seen this deck pop. It's a good deck, Ovika. And I can pop too.
Fire and Ice Sugar, deal damage. I'm gonna deal two damage to something to spread the love a little bit.
Should I? If you don't do that, I won't exile Jinji on your next turn.
Well, let's look at the board. What do we have in the board? This is giving him tokens.
Yeah.
This Impact Tremors too, right? These are basically both Impact Tremors?
Yeah, yeah.
And this is big Impact Tremors.
So he's also just gonna be 13 damage
that's
to the
true.
Face.
That is true.
I'm a fair magic player. And remembering that me and Sean are best friends.
Bestest of friends.
I'm gonna blow up the orc army instead. What?
So when he pops off and kills all of us with the Purphoros, well, no. So right now it is 4 damage when creatures entered.
Yep. I'm gonna draw my card.
Yes.
Now I'll pay one colorless. I'll play Arcbound Ravager. It comes in modular one.
I have two triggers. I have a Rissic trigger and a Sauron trigger. I'll make an orc army. And then are you paying? Not paying. I will draw for turn.
For good math and because I wanted you to draw a card because we're best friends. I'll pay two colors. Yep. To activate Tomb of the Spirit Dragon. And I get one life for each colorless creature I control. So one, two, three. Fair. Go ahead.
Untap. I will draw. Yeah, I'll just pass and I can just play it by ear, I guess. Yeah.
Untap. Upkeep. Draw.
And muy interesante.
Muy interesante.
¿Qué haces, amigo? ¿Qué quieres?
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. I'm gonna cast one with the multiverse.
Yikes.
It's an enchantment. It says you may look at the top card of your library anytime. You may play lands and cast spells from the top of your library. Once during each of your turns, you may cast a spell from your hand or the top of your library without paying its mana cost.
Trigger, trigger. I get a second Orc army, did you pay for Ristu?
I did not.
Draw.
I will also trigger a third path iconoclast. It'll make me a soldier. And each of you will take 4 damage total. 2 from Purphoros, 1 from the Whitty, and 1 from Impact Tremors.
Resolves?
Sure does.
Yikes, yep.
Okay, so I will look at the top card of my library. I will look at my hand. Even more hilarious.
This is not the turn you're looking for.
He can cast a spell for free.
Let him pass.
Fuck it. I'll cast Expropriate.
Ooh! Yikes.
Oh my god, almighty.
That's good trigger.
Yep. And it will also trigger my third path.
Rhystic trigger.
All right, so I get another orc, and I get draw a card.
And then I will make another.
Well, hold on. I think if I don't respond, I think we're dead.
Freak, yeah, we are, dude.
He's gonna get at least one more turn, dude. Like, I think I gotta get rid of the Purphoros, right?
All right, expropriate on the stack.
I mean, what do you think, Lynch? That's probably the worst thing,
this
right?
is coming out next turn.
This
for
is on
sure.
cast, so you guys are gonna take 4.
Yeah.
Okay, because if he takes another turn, I think we're dead, like with Purphoros out.
I don't know, that's why I'm like going back and forth. Like, is this a good time to cast this spell? Or am I being too premature?
I've only seen one expropriate resolve in a pot I play with and the person did not win because of it.
I agree. Ever. That's why it's one of those cards. It's like, is this a good time to play it? Am I gonna be regretting playing this?
I'm regretting not having open mana.
I think I can get rid of the Purphoros, but I just want to make sure that it's the best thing to hit before he takes his next turn.
I think it is because he's pinging us, dude.
Yeah,
it's doing the most.
It gets rid of two. Right?
So I'm gonna tap one. I'm gonna cast March of Otherworldly Light. I'm gonna exile some stuff for its casting cost, but let me read it first. It says, an additional cost to cast this spell, I may exile any number of white cards from my hand. It costs two less to cast for each card exiled this way. I can exile target artifact, creature, or enchantment with mana value X or less. So I'm gonna exile Jazal Goldmane and For the Emperor to make it cost four less, targeting Purphoros.
One other thing, hold on. Is this each turn?
Mm-hmm.
How many cards do you in hand?
Five.
I don't know, man. We're screwed because these are both good options.
Yep.
I mean, Ray, lead this again.
I can do that too, if that's the better option.
I can get that as well. I don't.
Because here's the thing. Right. It says choose. It doesn't say target. So he could take Sauron. He could take Ginger.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I mean.
I mean, I can hit that. I have enough to where I can hit that with this spell if you'd rather hit that. I could get rid of that with this spell. If we want to, but then Purphoros is still there.
I think he just has a good board, dude.
That's what I'm saying. So is it Purphoros or that is worse, right? I guess.
Because that had to resolve, mm-hmm. right? And then you did this in response. There's no way we could have stopped the expropriate by blowing that up.
Yep.
Nope.
It's just that, like, I don't see a good situation here.
Oh, if we're talking about what we're voting, I don't think we give him extra turns, period. No matter what he takes.
But, well, I am going to get an extra turn.
Right. Yeah. That's what I'm saying. He's going to get one turn no matter what because he votes. With this on the ballot, there's no way, dude. There's no way. If you give him more than the one turn he's going to get, we have lost. I can promise you that.
Yep.
I mean, here's the thing. This kills us slower, right? So, I mean, I don't know what he has in his hand, right?
Well, I think stopping him from... Because this
Because the free
him,
spell's crazy.
That's the free...
That's you may crazy. Look at the top card anytime. Mm-hmm. You may play lands and spells from the top of your library.
Mm-hmm. I know.
Once each turn, you may cast him... a spell from your hand or the tabular without paying. I think you got to do this because he's going to get the extra turn.
I say blow it up.
It says, as an additional cost to cast this spell, I may exile any number of white cards from my hand. It costs two less to cast for each card exiled this way. Exile target artifact, creature, or enchantment with mana value X or less. So I'm going to exile For the Emperor, Jazal Goldmane, Boros Charm, and Nayali the Sun's Vanguard, which will make it cost eight less, and I will target one with the multiverse.
That's it?
Yep, does that resolve?
You're not targeting anything else? Man, that is a lot of cards to get rid of.
I know, and, well, I can't even play them, so.
I think that's a play, Lynch. I think that's a good one. If he's gonna take, if, like, we can't counter expropriate, so it's gonna happen.
Expropriate's a bitch.
Where's your fierce guardianship?
Didn't draw into it. Wait, hold on. Uncast.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
I'm good at numbers. I'm just trying to go and draw.
Draw?
Yeah.
Well, maybe I can meet back.
That's why I want you to draw.
Sorry, on trigger, Orc Army.
Hold on. Mystic. Dear Satan, please give him the fierce guardianship.
Got it.
It was an island.
Okay, so that's all I can do. I assume that resolves? Question mark?
Thank you.
Are you really just giving him our. He's going to take our commander.
Not mine.
Why?
So I'm going to sack it.
One with the multiverse.
You're going to take your commander.
Yep. You have no mana.
It's for free.
Yeah, he can sack it instant speed. Yep.
I will make you pay.
I will make you pay.
In response.
Uh-huh.
To March of the Otherworldly Light?
To, yeah.
Okay. On the stack.
On the stack then?
Yeah, right.
Packed.
Oi!
Oh, no, he countered it, dude. Oh.
Hold on.
Cannot pay.
Do your thing. Draw.
Five. Please, Satan, please.
Draw. I needed something to shuffle my stuff.
Is horrible.
I've never drawn so many cards and then not been able to do shit.
I know. Well, the best part is he just let us talk it all out and he knew he had it.
Had to sit
All my friends would have been sweating. They would have been able to hide it.
No!
That's awful.
I wanted to yell, but
how do you have the pack that I didn't draw into anything? Oh, I am like, oh I'm going to have to discard dude. It.
Well, that's what I top decked.
Look you top decked it?
Yeah, that's I why hope I was you, like, I hope you're gonna go
I'm sorry.
That
it's been real, brother.
I'm sorry that you're not gonna win this game. You had the best
response
chance.
To the pact. Response. All right.
Tears.
So pact happens.
Suffered.
Trigger third path iconoclast.
Fuck.
Each of you will take four.
I exiled four cards for nothing, guys.
Yeah. Expropriate. Resolves,
yeah.
Or expropriate cast. I get third path iconoclast again. Each of you will take another four.
That's another four?
Yep.
You should have taken eight on the turn so far.
Yep.
Everything resolves. Expropriate is now happening. What's going on?
For the pact resolving, I'm just gonna put this on top of my library so I don't forget to pay the 5 beginning of my next upkeep so you guys don't just take them.
I was gonna say that's like our only chance. So you don't got any way to make him not able to pay 5.
Okay, so pact resolves, you put your dice on top. With those two things off the stack, I'm gonna use Arcbound Ravager's activated ability, sacrifice an artifact to put a plus one counter on this. I will sacrifice.
Sir Ginger?
Ginger has come in and out a lot.
May she rest in peace. God bless her.
All you need to do is some more cookie dough, throw it in the oven, you'll get another.
To put a plus one counter on this. And then I'm also gonna sacrifice.
You don't wanna do the Black Blade for Ford?
Oh, he can take, I thought it was creature, it's a permanent?
He can take any permanent.
Any permanent.
He can take a land, he can take your soul ring.
You smell like toast.
And I just don't know if you want to give him, because we're all going to die, so the best thing you can do is not give him these things.
Well, understanding with the card, reading the card, I guess, probably would have been.
Yeah, reading the card explains it.
Probably crazy. After some wise counsel from a dear friend, I will also sacrifice all these guys. I will sacrifice all these to Arcbound Ravager's ability. Putting 4 plus and plus encounters on this.
Including the mana rocks?
Yeah, don't forget your mana rocks, bro. Come on, he's gonna kill you anyway. Just do it for the lulls. He'll have to take a waste.
This is so painful.
Like a tomb.
I'm honest with you, dude. I can still take one of your lands.
Yeah, just give him take a land.
And I would probably take the ancient tomb.
Yeah, just let him take the ancient tomb. At least he's gotta take 2 life for the ancient tomb instead of the free 2 from the Sauron.
Agree with that.
I'll sacrifice these.
All of them, and to itself? It can sack itself?
Mm-hmm.
Sacrifice and artifact.
Yep.
Nothing there to put a plus and plus encounter on. These die. Any triggers from me sacking? Just pain, tears, and
suffering.
It's gonna be a long car ride home, Sean.
I have so many Lord of the Rings cards in my hand that I was so excited to play.
Expropriate reads, for 7 and 2 blue, Council's Dilemma. Starting with you, each player votes for time or money. For each time vote, take an extra turn after this one. For each money vote, choose a permanent owned by the voter and gain control of it. Exile, expropriate.
So you choose first?
I will choose first and take an extra turn.
I guess I will choose not time. What are the votes?
Time or money?
I guess I will give you money.
I will also vote money.
Okay. Money, money, money.
Money, money, money.
Money, money, money.
All right, expropriate resolves. I will be taking an extra turn. I will take Sauron. He's tapped.
Fuck.
I will take the Sol Ring.
Well, doesn't technically the Greaves stay on it until I pull it off? Even though I control it?
I think so, yes. Technically, yeah. Yeah.
I guess. That I don't know if it's gain control or
Well,
whatever.
No, but I can eventually move it.
Yeah.
Like, because you take him, those are on him, but yeah. Because I control it, my turn, if it gets there,
and
I can.
It's like a land on the idol.
I know, but Osgiliath is like.
It's pretty fun.
Is spicy.
You're going to have to have white mana to use it. If it helps your decision, I cannot activate the Osgiliath.
I'll take your Eidolon.
Yeah. I couldn't activate him if I wanted to, because this has to have a mana go into
so.
It.
He gets +1/+1 for each creature I control and +1/+1 for each aura I control. Right now he's a 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8. He an 8/8. I'm gonna need another die. All right, I'm gonna go to my next turn then. I will untap.
Don't tell him about the trigger.
Yeah.
Upkeep.
Maybe he'll miss it.
Oh wait, no, I'm gonna pay my pact trigger. That's 5 mana, correct?
So double blue.
Double blue. Double blue and 3. Okay, so.
Expropriate is exiled.
Expropriate, sneaking into my graveyard like that.
Cheater!
Tap the Sol Ring to add a blue red. Use the blue, red, and the colorless, and then one more for 5.
Boom.
All right.
Pass?
Draw.
Scoop?
I already knew what this was. So that is not what I wanted to be. So I'll tap for 3, and I will cast Rhystic Study.
Oh, paying for my tax?
I will pay your tax.
Oh.
Yeah. That will trigger the Iconoclast and will make me another dude. I have 4 dudes over here and 1 just came into place.
Which we lose 4 life?
4 life. Then I'm going to use the one with the multiverse trigger. I'm gonna cast Vicious Shadows.
What does that do, Sean?
It is an enchantment for 6 and a red. Whenever a creature is put into a graveyard from play, you may have Vicious Shadows deal damage to target player equal to the number of cards in that player's hand.
Yikes. Let's go, baby. So
that makes another guy, right?
That will trigger their best thing.
Thank God. Times are tough, bro. Look at, you have no cards, I got 1 card.
Oh, I was like.
Let us be excited.
I was like, we're dead. Like,
yeah, that's true. It doesn't really do much to you guys. Third path Iconoclast will trigger, making me another dude. Each of you will take 4.
Now what happens?
3, 4, 5. Purphoros is online. Now I go to combat.
You should have let him have the Rhystic Study trigger so he'd have 13 cards in hand. That would have been funny.
I'm so worried about him getting a free counter spell or doing something silly to me that I'm just like,
hey, you can take the sauce. It's all right. We'll just take it back.
I would get very lost. I know. All right, so I'm going to go to combat now.
Yeah, you're in combat.
Yeah. I'm going to swing. The Eidolon has got two more power now because of the two more creatures that have entered the battlefield.
Crazy.
We'll count again when we do the thing.
Gentlemen, it's been an honor playing with you this evening.
Swing out. So I think this is how I want to do this. The Sauron, you're at 18, so 10 plus 7 plus 1 at him is 18. You're at 21.
I counted how much different combinations of way I could play different spells in my hand. Like I had so many fantasies. I fantasized about, I can play this or this combination. So
10, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21 going there.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Six, and these going at Lynch. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11. You're at 13, damn it.
And I have a blocker.
Yeah, you have a blocker.
But if you block, you will die, because you'll take damage. You'll take 12 damage. He did that on purpose. Yep, you literally, if anyone plays a spell, you're dead.
Yep. Yeah, Sauron's pretty good in this deck.
And the deck, it doesn't go in.
That doesn't happen. Yeah, just make Sauron the commander, play it exact same way.
Okay, those are my decks. I go to one.
Did any swings come to your way?
Are you dying?
I'm dead.
No. He dies. His soul ring goes back to him.
Thanks, brother.
Second main phase, I'm going to take a damage. I'm going to cast a Brightstone Ritual. Add red to my mana pool for each goblin in play.
Okay, so spell cast.
Add another third path. Deals 4 damage to each of you.
That's an instant. So I die, lose.
I'm not paying. And that's all I do.
Bowmasters, Orcish Boarmasters, Nazgul, Orcish, Gizlat the Brash,
Jesus.
Investigator, Corazals of Umbra, and even the Call of the Ring.
Ooh, ring.
I had so much flavor.
You were foolish to leave me alive.
John, I have good news for you.
Yeah. That comes in tap, because I don't have a mountain or a flick. Then I'll pay 3. Unfortunate for you, I have a Growing Rites of Itlamok.
Oh.
And I will pass. This legendary enchantment says, when Growing Rites of Itlamok enters the battlefield, I look at the top 4 cards of my library. I may reveal a creature card from among them and put it into my hand. I put the rest at the bottom of my library in any order. At the beginning of my end step, if I control 4 or more creatures, I transform the Growing Rites of Itlamok. Trigger, I will look at the top 4. I can reveal a creature. Oh my god. I will Mir.
Ristic?
Jet Mir, the Nexus of Revels. Look how amazing that little foil on is.
There wasn't a blast.
Can't pay the Ristic, so I will draw.
Yep. And then this will go on the bottom. And then I will put this into my hand. I then pass the turn.
Oh boy.
The Vizzoli is going to do you bad.
I would love to see you get out of this gambit I've set up for you, sir. He can sneeze on me and I'll die.
Okay, I may play lands.
Okay.
I'll play this exotic orchard from the top of my library. Oh dear lord. For free from the top of my library, Dream Halls. It's an enchantment for 3 and 2 blue. Instead of paying the casting cost of a spell of any color, its caster may choose and discard a card that shares at least 1 color with that spell. If that spell has X in its casting cost, X is 0. So it works for everybody, but I do have a third path iconoclast trigger on the stack. There's 7 here now, actually, and then 1 just came into play.
Take 4.
So you'll take 4.
I got you, dog.
Discard Balmor, Battle Mage, to cast Ovika, my commander. Actually get it out on the battlefield. ETBs, deals 4 damage.
My god. Why have you forsaken me?
There is no god where you are.
There is no god where you are.
There is no god.
I'll tap for a blue and Soul Ring for 2 and cast Selundi Vision. That will trigger Ovika, and it will make me 3 1-1 red Phyrexian goblin creature tokens, which is because it's its mana cost.
That's another 12 damage.
And that's 12 damage coming in.
That's a good game there, John.
No, I'm dead.
GG.
You deserve it after that chunky hot sauce for sure.
You know, at least we didn't let him win off the, like, right away off Expropriate.
Right.
Yeah, I still had to do a little work.
Like, the fact that we didn't lose off the extra turn from Expropriate, on that board state, that I'm actually kind of proud of that. That's actually,
yeah, that we actually were able to bond together to like prevent that from happening.
We bonded in sadness.
Bonded in sadness.
Ray, how do you feel about still not getting a win yet?
Oh, my God.
Are you still?
I could not have had a better start and not a quicker finish. I don't understand.
You have that a lot, that though. You always start well, dude. And you just have trouble finishing.
Well, I just got red man on that.
Just gonna
last
lay
turn.
On
there's
that.
The other right there. Just gonna yep.
Take an 18-second pause. Good, nice. Always, to reminisce on that. Ruminate a little bit.
You always come out so strong, and you get all the attention toward you. You gotta learn to slow roll. That's what Larry's really good at. Larry's really good at that slow roll, yeah. And then he smacks you when you think he's not doing anything.
But even if I had done that slow, like I don't.
He is.
Yeah. Like Icarus, you flew too close to
it's,
the sun.
It's not even the fact that like you went in slow, it's just that you had Eidolon. that you just you had somebody who was like actively stopping.
Now you see responses. Why you shouldn't have killed my orc. You should have continued to bully Sean.
Oh, the third path iconoclast?
Yeah, he was talking about killing them.
To be fair, so, you're probably right, but I hit him for 13. It seemed like
this is why you can't do the whole like fair thing. Like, oh, I'm gonna roll to see who I hit. Like, dude, you gotta stop the engine. But I understand why you felt bad. I do get it.
Yeah.
But plus, now all the comments are like, he shouldn't have felt bad. He should have just roasted Sean.
Yeah, there's a guy in our play group that if he's alive, no mercy. He must die. Because even if one life, no mana, no cards in hand.
Every group's kind of got that one spiky player.
Yeah, it's you.
I definitely not me, but I do try to deflect a lot with my name being Sean, not the threat. Yeah, that's my full name.
You should have been like, I just had to not feel bad. I got to kill a person.
Yeah, sure. I don't think, I probably could have slowed him down.
So, well, I feel like this deck has a pretty good success rate for you. I feel like every time I've seen you play it, it does really well. It pops pretty good.
Thanks, man. It's kind of the similar build to like Locust God.
Yeah, it reminded me of
Locust
God.
I even think I should maybe run Locust God in here, but I don't run a lot of, I'm not trying to wheel and draw a bunch of cards. I'm just trying
to That's what makes it different than Locust God is you're not abusing the wheel effects for your win condition. Yeah. You're just abusing, I'm going to cast non-creature spells and create tokens.
Yeah, how many non-creature spells? Everything that's not a creature. Like, that's just so many things. Artifacts, enchantments, instant sorceries, planeswalkers, battles.
Good, another
thanks,
good
man.
Win. Another good win for the home
team.
Hey, every other Friday, check out I Hate Your Deck. We appreciate the support. See you next time. Or not. Maybe we'll see you another time.
We'll be here whether you're here or not.
Yeah. Are you still watching?
Yeah.
Join Patreon if you're still watching.
Yeah.
We appreciate the support.
Someone figure out where these dice are from. We don't know.
Ray gave them to me, but he can't remember where they came from.
I know where they came from, but it's just in a clear plastic bag at a coffee shop.
If you want to support I Hate Your Deck, please consider joining our Patreon. It's an excellent community that we have built with people from around the world where we play Magic in our Discord using Spelltable. If you haven't had a chance to play online Magic yet, try out our Discord. It's a great community where people are gaming daily. And every Thursdays we have Commander Day where people play all day and night, but the community's gotten so big, Commander Day is almost every day at I Hate Your Deck. I Hate Your Deck would like to thank our sponsor, No Pulp Media. It's where we're shooting right now, and it's where a lot of people come to record music or do podcasts. So if you're looking to do that, check out No Pulp Media here in Long Beach.
Hey, it's time for the random Patreon shoutouts. I'd like to thank Sunday, Luke Cook, and Gabriel Mendez. Thanks, y'all.
If you want a shout out, you need to be a tier 4 or tier 5 patron where we give shout outs. Now, we love all of our patrons, but it's just one of the perks of being a tier 4 or tier 5 patron. Without you patrons, we wouldn't be where we are today, and we wouldn't be able to keep making content. So thank you so much for helping us make this show a reality, and we're really excited to keep bringing you great content for the years to come. I can't wait to be able to bring my son on the channel once he gets old enough, let me tell you.
I Hate Your Deck. Wizards of the West Coast, tapping out and slinging spells. Wizards of the West Coast, tapping out and slinging spells. I Hate Your Deck. your deck. Wizards of the West Coast, I hate your deck. Join the I Hate Your Deck Patreon exclusive Discord to get the various benefits and be able to play Commander daily with people from around the world in our global community. I Hate Your Deck.